Hello and welcome to the Little Gypsy Butterfly Mixed Media Canvas. This is a full workshop and I'm so glad you're here with me. This actually was a test. This was a test workshop that I am preparing for a live face-to-face class here in Daytona. And it came out great and I thought, well, I edited it and I thought this is great to offer to my YouTube friends, so you've got it. So I hope you'll enjoy, and there is a product and supply list below. So sit back and relax and enjoy and let's have some fun together. Okay, this is a great beginner class or a class just for anyone. It's just lots of fun. I hope you enjoy, and if I inspire you, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I will see you in the workshop. Okay, we are going to start with some Americana paint, probably some DecoArt thrown in there, but you'll have a list. And I'm going to make a nice background for our butterfly. And I'm just shaking this up a little bit and pull out a palette. This is your wood canvas, and take some color. And I'm going to put some. Let's see, this is country red, and put some pumpkin. I don't know if I'm going to stay with those colors, but we can start. And you can do this with a sponge, a brush, you know, whatever. I'm going to just do it with this little spongy thing here and just kind of put some colors on here. And mix in. And I think what we're going to do is I'm going to work on the top portion, or maybe do quarters of colors, you know, and then different colors. And then when we put the butterfly on, we can quarter that out too. So let's start with this color on this side. And then let's think, maybe some blue here, some purples here, some greens there. That's looking really cool. I like that. It's nice and soft. I can always go in and add more magenta, a magenta color, or a purple. And let's see, there is really a beautiful color that I'm like totally crazy about, and it's called mulberry. And I'll put some of that on in here. Just mix it in a little bit. And this is like a real, I love this color. So just kind of mix that in a little bit. Very pretty, very soft, and then some darkness in there from the mulberry really gives it, it's a richness. So let's pick on the other side and see what color we want to put on the other side. Okay, so let's mess around with another color. You know, let's put some, I think I'm going to put some blue. So this is true blue I'm shaking out. And this is uniform blue. Let's see how this goes. A little, oh, I see. You gotta really shake these suckers up. Yeah, they sit. I really need a darker blue. So let's see, let's go through the blues and see. I have navy and midnight. Ooh, let's do little midnight. see how that goes. Oops, and I'm gonna do it up in this area here. Adding. Putting that in there. And that brighter blue too, just kind of lightening it up a little bit. Looking really pretty. Yeah. And then of course you can always throw some white too to even lighten it up a little bit. I have some whitewash white I'm gonna kind of throw in there. I sound like a crazy person banging the bottles around, but if you don't, I don't want too much. Just a little. A little bit more of that midnight. And you know, this can be your first layer. You can go back and definitely go back in and after it dries and see how it dries and then add in more dark, more light. Just wanted to have a really nice background for the butterfly. Okay. That a little bit more even there. Okay, so I'm gonna soak my sponges and get myself, let's see, I get another pouncer here. I have to get some more of those big ones. I'm liking those big ones. Okay, so now I'm going to do a little bit of green. Maybe some green, and let's add in a little bit of yellow too. Oops. Not pretty, huh? Look at that. Liking that, huh? Okay, so this is the, let's see, yellow green. Very nice. I keep messing up this color here. Okay. So that's kind of bringing, mixing the blue in very nicely with the green. And I think on this side, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put some yellow and move that red down, that orangey move that down a little bit. Now, if you have, you know, golden paints or whatever, you can use whatever, but I'm trying to show you that you can use your craft paints and get really good, a really good outcome with them. And that one's a little bit more purpley, but I'm gonna get where is that like luscious color that I just crazy about? Some plum and let's see, add some plum to that. And just kind of I really want that one a little bit more orangey up top, so I'm going to add some more orange in there. And this is orange twist, so put that in there. And I'm going to get a different, I'm just going to use a little sponge here. And kind of add that in because I really want that to lighten up here. Oops. Just get a little, that's not quite the orange that I'm going for. I need, here's orange flame. Let's try this one. Yeah. Orange flame, and let's see. This one and see how that kind of blends. Yeah. Yeah, this is more of the orange that I was going for. Very much more. Much brighter, yes. Loving that. And a little bit of that country red back in there. Okay, so let's let that dry, and I've got my kind of corners all colored. You can do that and let that all dry, and then with your excess paint you can always put it in your journal and use it for something else, and don't waste anything, you know, use it, stencil it onto something and use your paint. So those, we've got our four patches there, and then we can do more. We want to do some stenciling on the background over that. Next I'm going to go over sketching out the butterfly and some flowers. The butterfly sketch will be available at my group, my Facebook group. It's a private group, no boundaries. It's made up of some of my student artists that take my free or purchased workshops, and they share their artwork there. And it's a nice group, but the file will be there for you free if you want to go over there for the butterfly, or you can just watch this and make your own butterfly. So it's totally up to you, but I sure would love to see you over there if you'd like to join. Okay, so now let's make our butterfly or flowers or, you know, whatever you decide. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make an, since my canvas is 8x8, I'm going to make an outline, which is 8x8. So this way I have an idea of how big I want my butterfly or flowers or, you know, whatever. This is just my sketchbook, so you know, it's no big deal. Okay. So now that you've got the size of the canvas, you know how big everything has to be. And the little butterfly I made, I just kind of, and we can start with the center piece if you want. And just, I wanted to make her a little bit quirky. I made this kind of a little bit odd here. So I'm going to go in and just hang that low. She's just kind of funky, so. Get my other pencil. I don't see. I don't see my sketching pencil. And and my erasers. So, and then don't forget when you're, you know, done, you got it the way you want it, just scan it. You could put any design, doodle on her or whatever. Just make her cool, funny. And then you can, you know, decorate your wings anyway, but at least you've got the basic little cute little butterfly down. This erase is so much better, but I've got to get it in kind of a tip form because it's so big. Okay, so you can go over this with a pen and make it darker, but basically you can just scan this or just cut it out. Use it if you're not looking to keep it. Okay, so that's basically it. Now, if you wanted to do it a flower for there, what I would do is, you know, do the same thing. Draw your canvas. Whoops. The size of your canvas for you. So this way. And then you can always resize anything on your printer. You know, if you decide that you want it smaller, or if later on you want to do a bigger one and you want it bigger, you'll have it. Okay, so now you can do is you can draw, you know, if you wanted some flowers. flowers. And I would do, you know, a stem. Because remember, you have to cut these out. Then you can do doodling and everything in your flowers. And then just, at least you have the size of your canvas down, so you know. And let's see, we should make another one here. And, you know, you can do whatever flower you want. If you want to make sunflowers, or you want to make poppies, you know, whatever you decide. I'm just doing that, these as an example. Excuse me, take a little bit of coffee there, and then you can make your leaves separate if you want, you know, on another piece of paper. But at least you have this. You can cut this out, put this down, and then, you know, do your leaves if you want to. Do them separately if you want to do one on this sheet. Then you can just, you know, whatever kind of leaves you decide. Or if you want to do, you know, smaller, there's so many different shaped leaves you can do. So, or you can just add that in later with collage paper, which would be cool. And if you have any stamps for leaves, just stamp out the leaves on your collage paper and then use that. So you can do that too. But today we're going to use the butterfly. So, but that's just an idea for you how to get your, and I like all kinds of flowers. So if you want to do sunflowers, or I love poppies, that's a wonderful. But this, I did this because I can do a lot of doodling on these and make them really fun. So that's that for now. So let's get back to the canvas and see what else we want to do to it before we put our butter. I'm going to use the butterfly. So I'm going to put the butterfly down, but I don't know if I'm going to decorate her first, or, you know, what I'm going to do yet, because I'm still want to work on that background. Okay. Let's look at this and see. Now we've got the colors on here. And it's looking good, but we're going to get some stencils and figure out what you want to do. Do you want it? I'm going to just adjust this camera a minute. So sorry, guys. Yeah. Okay. This is my new workspace. So this is actually, I believe, the first one in my new. It started off in my old workspace, and now it's ending up in my new workspace. So a little bit different for me. Lighting looks okay. You can see the colors we last finished with. It's a little bit darker in person, this area here, but it's kind of the pretty good. I don't want to adjust it too much. I've been adjusting, and then I wind up adjusting it where it's too dark or too bright, or, you know. So this looks pretty, almost the correct, the way that it looks in person. And then so now I'm going to get out my stencils, and I'm kind of thinking, do I want my stencils to be just in paint? Do you want them to be with gesso, or anything thicker? Well, not really a paste or anything, because when you're going to lay down, or you're going to, you can either lay, cut out your butterfly, or you can just transfer it on. And what I would do, would I, if I was going to transfer it, you can transfer it. I've got white transfer paper, because if you're doing a dark background, you want to do it so you can see it, so you can transfer it with the white transfer paper. But what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to stencil just in paint, because I don't want it to be too textured, because when I lay that beautiful butterfly down, now you're getting the sketch of this, so you can make it smaller if you want. Now it covers, the way I drew it is to cover almost this whole page, almost. So what you could do is you could like stencil the outer edges, because the inside's going to be covered with the butterfly, unless you want to do the whole thing and then just, like I was talking about, transfer the sketch, so that you'd get what you have in the background. You'd have the outline of the butterfly, but you'd keep all the background into the butterfly, and then you could add more. So you could do it that way too. I don't know. You know, it would work out really cool either way. So you decide what you want to do. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just stencil around and stamp around the edges here, and then figure out what you want to do with the size. If you want to paint it, or you want to just stain it, you know, a nice wood stain, or you want to put it the colors that you put in here on the sides. I don't know yet what I'm going to do with that. So what's great about these wood blocks is you could just hang them if you don't want to frame them. So, you know, whatever you put on the side will show nicely. So let's see. I'm going to get out some stencils and some stamps. Let's do something a little bit interesting. And I know you guys will probably have some great ideas, so I can't wait to see what you do. So let's get started. Okay. May have a little bit noise here. I hope you don't hear the washing machine. But it may be in the background a little bit. So what I'm doing is I'm stenciling, and I'm trying to do it in a color that stands out. Like this was so dark, this blue. So I'm trying to do a color that will stand out on that. And I could have done white. That would have been a really nice one too. But let's see, I think I'll do the blue spray paint on this side. I'm using the same stencil, so that looks really pretty. And I'm just trying to keep this flat, because I want to be able to put my butterfly or flowers or whatever you decide you want to do on there. But I'm just cleaning my stencil off on, because I want to reuse it, so I'm just wiping it off on some paper that I could, you know, use later in something. Okay, so I'm going to use it again, and I think on this one I'll do the yellow. Maybe I'll have to do that again. Let's see. Oh, this one not spraying well. Kind of icky. So let's see. Yeah, oh, well, kind of mushy, but it'll have to do. Just looking to get some color and design on there. So, let's get that cleaned. Okay. This one. That one. Oh, let's see. What do I want to put on that one? I think I want to put the... that's really icky, and it's bothering me. I don't like that. So, take some of that up. Okay. A color. I did blue, I did the red. I don't want to do green on here, so I may just do the orange on that one. Let's see if it, oh, you know what? No, I'll do the burgundy color. Yeah, that's pretty. I'm just cleaning that off. Okay. I've got to bring my pail down here with water in it so I could put my stencils in, you know, since I don't have a sink here. Not yet, anyway. So that looks really pretty. Okay, so I'll give it some background. I'll let that dry. And then, you know, I'm going to put some more. I think I'm going to put some white, do some white stenciling across the edge there. And I'm going to print out my butterfly and then cut it out and see how much of the background shows. And I don't know if I'm going to make it as big as I did. So I may downsize it a little bit in size because the actual size of it actually covers. Excuse me. The whole page, and I don't think I want to do that anymore. You know how things change, you know, you kind of change and do something different than what you first started out with. And once you kind of look at your piece, you know, then you can kind of change things and tweak things and figure out, you know, what you want to do. And you definitely could just draw a butterfly on here or flowers. So, but I just like the idea of all the different patches of color in the background. So, and then once we get all the stenciling done, and if you want a stamp, I mean, that's really cool. That keeps it, you know, flat. So we can do some stamping on it. It's just so many things you can do. And then make the centerpiece your butterfly or your flower or whatever you decide to put on there. Okay, so let's let that dry and I'll be right back. Okay, so let's get another stencil. I love this stencil. Now, everything I'm using is DecoArt so far. So, Americana, DecoArt, you know, I don't know if you saw one of my videos where I took the spray bottles I made. It may have been in one of my workshops. I don't remember. But I took all their, the paints that they had in their spray bottles, and I went and purchased these online at Amazon and put them in these little bottles. They seem to work better. After a while, all these bottles of sprays, and that's delusions, inks. I mean, I love all that stuff, but I get real tired of the nozzle, having to clean the nozzles constantly. So I just went and bought these little ones, and so far they're working. So I'm going to put this down. This is another stamp of, not a stamp, a stencil of, just wish I could get something to spray better. These spray bottles just don't do it. This is a really cool stencil, but as you can see, it's not really coming out as anything because the spray bottles don't. They kind of just, yeah, squirt. So we'll just do that. I'm getting the background a little bit. Now this one is. There we go. I've got some splattering on that. I'm going to take this and clean it off on a sheet. Some of that white and yellow out there. Okay, then I'm going to let that dry. Actually, I'm going to find my dryer. And since I moved everything into my new studio, I kind of misplaced some things. You know, when we were trying to get things ready and move things, I, you know, at the last minute, I kind of took things and just said, okay, let's stick this in there, let's stick that in there. And of course, one of the things was my little hand dryer. So I will be right back. And I'm going to, heat dry this, so get it done faster. Okay, so let's see. Now, that kind of didn't sit well with me. It kind of got funky, but there's my cutout there. So, I'm going to put some stars in, I believe, all around, and I'm going to use the Americana Multi-Satin, and it's called Chick, the color. So it's kind of in the yellow side. And let's see. Yeah, this sits on here. Okay, so got some stars on there. And it's really kind of yellow. It's a very pale yellow, but I'll have to darken this a little bit so you can see it. Just wiping my stencil a little bit clean. And let's see. This is the lighting, I guess. See it better like that. Let's just get this a little bit darker. And that's a little bit too bright, so let's, yeah, that's better, but let's see, it's a little bit too dark, huh? That's better. You can kind of see the richness in the colors there, okay? And then this lovely little sweetie pie is going to go in there. So that'll be cool. So let's let this dry. Actually, I'm going to hit it with a heat gun. So that's kind of it. And then you can think about the next possibility. And what I think I want to do is I want to definitely want to have some flowers in here. Maybe coming in like all around her, the little butterfly. So let's think about that and let that dry even more. Still a little tacky, so I don't want to mess it up. And oops, and then we'll be right back. I'm going to start working on the butterfly. And I decided on kind of orangey color. So let's see. I'm just using my DecoArt still. And I am using the Americana Poppy. Multi-surface, the satin again, and I'm just gonna, I cut her out, and a lot of times, you know, I'll work on things before I cut them out, but this time I cut her out, and figure out what colors I want her. And I just printed her out on some heavy cardstock, nothing, no watercolor paper, nothing too heavy, because I really want her to be able to lay down nicely. And I'm going to be doing this with decoupage, so I don't want it too thick, because then that just doesn't sit down right. You have to start gluing. And You know, if you're not looking to glue or use double-sided tape, then don't go too thick on your paper. And since I'm putting acrylic over it, the paper will get nice and heavy anyway. So it's different when you're working with watercolors or very watery acrylics, then you want to use a heavier paper. But with the regular acrylics, you know, the plastic in them, it coats the paper. Okay, so I got the top. Now I want to do the bottom. Now what I want to show you is I actually darkened the, if you can see that, I darkened the stars. I made them more yellow, and I used the DecoArt Traditions, and this one is, let's see if I can get it in the light, Hansa Yellow Medium. So that's what I darkened them with, this, because they were just so light you could barely notice them, and I really wanted to give it a pop of color. So make it a little pleasing to the eyes. And now I have to think, what do I want on the bottom of her wing? You know, what color do I want to go with there? And really got to think about that. Let me attach this to me, my headset. Okay. Do I want to do like a nice creamy color with the orange? I don't want to do a red, but I could do another. This is shrimp. That's like a peachy color, but I'm thinking more in the lines of a kind of, let's see, green, or I have white, and there's just a lot of colors, you know, and there's another kind of, this is called peach silk. Ooh, that's pretty. I'll have to use that on something, but I don't think on this. Yeah. Here's another. Here's an almond color. That's pretty. But I don't know. That is pretty. Maybe I will go with the almond. I want to keep it light on the, because I want to decorate it, so I want to have a lighter background. And these paints, just remember, you have to really shake them, especially if they've been sitting a while. And this is almond, and this again is the Americana, the multi-surface satin. I love these paints, so. But just remember to shake well after they've been sitting a while. Okay, so let's go with that. You can use any brushes that you want, any size that comfortable for you. We're not doing any techniques with brushes, so it doesn't really matter. Just use your acrylic brushes, whatever size and shape. That's good for you. And you definitely could have used collaged paper or any of your jelly print paper and used it for the butterfly, you know, trace her onto that. And then I'm trying to do this very simply, only because I am doing this in a face-to-face, in person, and I don't want to get into too much because I'm very limited in hours. So this is just basically trying to try it out and see how long it takes and if I can do it and make it interesting without using too many supplies. So the least amount of supplies I have to bring, the easier it is on me and on them. So I don't want to, you know, that is really, that looks way, it's not that orange. Let me fix this. Wow. Woo. No, that's washed out. Let's just adjust it again. A little bit too. Goodness. Yeah, that's a little bit better, I think. I mean, it's pretty deep orange, but coming out way too colorful. Just adjust it a little bit. It's probably much better right there. Okay. Yeah, that's much better. Okay. So let that dry. And, I mean, you know, you can do, which I'm not going to do in the class, but I'm telling, you know, offering info to you, and I will to them too, but I'm not going to be doing any fancy embossing and all that stuff in the class. But you definitely could take this so much further and, you know, go crazy for this with this butterfly, and really, you know, you could put jewels on her and just really make her stand out magnificently with all the supplies that you have. And what I would do now, if I wasn't doing this in a class, and which I may do another one, but, you know, do it not in a class that I only have like 2 hours to do, is take some of my jelly print paper that I did on, let me go get that. I'll be right back. See, some of these papers that are just so cool. Wouldn't that be nice? That would have been really cool as the butterfly, but I would have to, in the class, have them make this. It would take forever to try to get them to make these with, you know, jelly prints and stencils. But if you have this and you're at the point of doing your butterfly, and you could, you know, just trace right on here, or just draw her, you know, right on here, and then put that on your sheet. Let me just move that a little bit so you can see that better. And just, you know, because I make all these things in advance, and, you know, that is definitely a project to use it on. Because, I mean, could you imagine? Even if you just did it for her wings, how cool, you know, with all you guys. I know, you know, a lot of you do these jelly prints. And what is this paper called? Deli paper? Yeah. Because it would kind of give it a transparent kind of, let's see what it would look like. You know, if you took one of these, well, it wouldn't really be, I guess it would be kind of transparent, and you just have it for, you know, the actual butterfly. So that would go really, I think it would be really cool. That's the other side. I'm trying to think which one would I probably use if I was doing it. Maybe that one. That one I would do. And I think that would look just beautiful, because it would be so thin, you know, like butterfly wings. That looks so cool. But I'll have to do that again in another class, where I just do it online and use our jelly prints and maybe make them, our deli paper together, and then make butterflies and flowers. So that's just an idea for you. And trying to think, what else do I want to do with this? I think I'm going to draw some flowers, and that'll be pretty easy to teach. So I just got to think, what colors do I want to put on here? And And what colors do I want to incorporate in here? And let's see, I keep hitting my, hopefully this is on, right? Keep hitting it. You get this little clip-on thing with your headphones, and I'm constantly smacking it around because I don't clip it on, because every time I do clip it on, I go to move, and then I'm clipped. So, let's see. Bring a little purple in there. That'd be nice, huh? I don't know what this, it's iris. That would kind of be really nice to throw in there, and, No pink. Okay, let me start with the purple. So I'm going to just add very simple flowers because we don't want to do anything too complicated. I don't know why this isn't coming out. I'm going to shake this. Now this is the Americana again, the satin, and it is iris. This one time I'm going to take a small brush. Oh, the little cap came off. Whoops. Just kind of make little random. Oops, let's get that off there. It had some icky. Three leaves, four leaves, you know, whatever. Let me just get this crusted thing off the top of this paint. I don't know how that happened. Very strange. You know, these poor paints were packed away. Not for very long. Oh, you know what? Probably. Yeah, they were kind of packed when I went away for Halloween, but they gotta be careful with your paints where you keep them stored. They can get lumpy. All kinds of things. Okay, so that's a little flower there. I'm just doing a little easy little flowers. That's a bunch of little circles together. And then you can decorate them in the middle. Different colors, and let me just clean this brush out. Get another color. I'm looking for a fuchsia kind of a color, and I'm trying to see which one of these has the color I'm looking for. I have to make it. Let's see. I have Flamingo in this, but that's not. So you kind of want the same, this purpley kind of pink, so. That's purple. So let me go see. if I have that, I'm going to come over to my stash of regular Americana and see what I have in here. And this is probably perfect. This is called Royal Fuchsia. Yes, there we go. And this is the Americana. Okay. Want them together. Basically three little circles. Okay. And you can keep doing that, you know, just keep adding flowers and, you know, bringing in colors that you like, which is a lot of fun. And I think I'm going to bring in some of the orange that is on our butterfly. So, and then our nice little butterfly will get our colors and go on there. And when your flowers dry, you can go over them again to make the color more opaque, because, you know, they sometimes the paint, because there's so much underneath it. So much color underneath, you may want to go over it again. So let's just hit that with the dryer and get that dried and then enhance all the colors on there. Okay, you can see I just outlined the butterfly with the Americana Black Writer, and it's cool. It's just, you know, just went around with it, with that, and I think that I may use that to finish decorating for the flowers to kind of, you know, make them pop. And we can go in there with the... little tip. Make them the little centers. I mean, you can use anything. If you have the liquid pearls, they work really cool. Or any kind of paint that's in one of these little... I love my fine liners. I think that's it. for the flowers around the edges there. Whoops. At any point during this, you could be ready to add your butterfly. But sometimes you have this tugging. Your inner voice is saying, come on, let's just push it a little bit more. Let's just see. And sometimes you need to listen to that. Maybe do a little brayering to add some more color and texture. Add more stenciling. Add more stamps. If you feel deep down that there's something more that you need to do, then just do it, because you will appreciate your work even more if you listen to your inner soul. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I am already attempting to go over this with some different colors. Kind of smoosh everything together more. I'm kind of putting those colors in the background more. And you can see that. You still have all your colors, but you know, you've got more distraction from it. You know, I needed to kind of get it going differently a little bit. So, also going to add some of that fuchsia in there. So those colors are still there, but they're very muted. And I can go around the sides and put color in along the sides. And the colors I used to do that was the Americana Deep Turquoise and the Vanilla and then the Fuchsia. Oops. All the same. And just do the sides of this real funky, like just kind of roll some paint around it. Just add a little bit more of the... Oh, actually, you know what I use? I use the Flamingo. Sorry about that. It wasn't Fuchsia. Use Flamingo. And I'm going to put more of that Flamingo on the sides. Finish off the sides, and then that'll all dry. And I can still see my color variation, you know, my four color palettes there. And I know it looks kind of crazy right now, but that's just makes me feel good. So, and let's see her, and she goes on here. She's gonna have like a really crazy background, so I'll be right back. Okay, what I did with the butterfly is I took the brayer with all the colors on it and I just went over the butterfly to kind of make it blend in with the background a little bit. And then what I'm going to do is I'm stenciling over it and adding some black to it. So when you see the butterfly, you'll see that she's almost already done. Okay, you can see that I went crazy with the black and white. So I did some black and white all over, just to give it some more fun. And I also went over and did this with a stencil, which I have out because I'm doing something with that on my door in my studio, I'm decorating it. So I had it out and I thought, well, that looks cool. So that's going to look really cool on there. Okay, so I got to let this dry. It's like globs of paint on here. And I will be right back. Okay, I'm going to go in with the fine line white and just kind of add a little bit to my flowers than I did the little black flowers. Can't really see the other ones too well, but at least, you know, it's a process and it just goes on, you know, and happens when you're doing this kind of mixed media. It's just, that's the fun of it. So, you know, I kind of turned everything around. It looks rather different now, but I love it. You know, there's certain colors that I'm not comfortable with. And even though I try, the painting just kind of wants to do what it wants to do. It just was calling to me to add these other colors and do this. So I did it. Sometimes you just have to listen to yourself, you know, listen to your creative soul and just go with it. You know, don't fight it. Totally loving this. Totally. And I can't wait to put her down. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to do the little dots in there, black and white. And then I'm going to go back and outline it again because it kind of got painted over, that black outline. I'm going to do that with my fine liner or with this writer, the black Americana. And I've been using all my paints today have been DecoArt, Americana, just using their colors, and I love them, and they just are so bright and cheery and just really cool. So she's gonna look cool there, isn't she? I love her. Okay, well, I'll be right back. Okay, let's make sure that I've got this on correctly, and yep. Okay, you can see kind of lost the butterfly. I put down the butterfly, but kind of lost it. So I'm going to take some. I was going to outline it in black, but I think I'm going to do the white. And I'm taking the fine liner. And I'm going to try it in the white and see how that looks. Oops. Oops, kind of pressing against the edge. Oop, not very straight, or not very steady. That's what I should say. Too much coffee today? I don't know. It doesn't really matter. And kind of, I think that pops it out better than the black would be. So okay, so that, yeah, that kind of gives it some definition there. And then when I go in and let that dry, and then go in and, you know, I have to actually do the actual butterfly's body. So I don't know if I'm going to do anything more to the wings. Maybe, yeah, well, maybe I will. What am I saying? Maybe I will. Maybe I'll put some white in here and do some stuff. But because it's kind of very busy, so I mean, I don't want to make it any more busier than it is. So I really want the butterfly to stand out. So when I think after I paint her and see, then I'll see if I want to do anything else to the wings. But I think that looks really pretty and fun. You know, it's fun. And that's it. And, you know, we've got not much more to do. I mean, you could put, like, jewels on here at this point would be nice. You know, like, if you have any. Oops, let's see. I always forget I have the headset on. And go off. And I'm going to pull it out one of these days. Let's see. I have some little stash here. I keep, like, you know, when I find things hanging around and I just kind of throw into a little box. See, I don't know, like, I don't know. What do you think? Can you see that? Maybe not. I can see it, but, you know, maybe some little, oh, you know what? Maybe bead her. How about that? Huh? How about beading her up? Like, paint her first. You know, the background color, white, black, whatever. Boy, I can't even pick up another one. And then just, oops, get white on you like I just did. And then put, oh, I'm like really liking that. So I may be doing that. Let me see how many I have. And I like the red. And I think, for some reason, I have a lot of red in here. I don't know where these all came from. So let me just not get it into, don't get into the white. I have to be so messy or I'm not happy, you know. Okay, so that's a cool idea. So we may be doing that. So let me just let this dry because I am going to just keep messing it up and messing it up. And then I'll be upset with myself. So, yeah, let's find some goodies and put it on. Ooh, look at that little goodie. I don't know if you can see that. Little, that'd be fun, huh? Somewhere. Buttons and any kind of cool stuff. I love these things. Oh, I love these things. They're so much fun. I used to use them a lot on my boxes that I would make, you know, my gypsy boxes with the tiles. And so, well, I have a lot of red beads, so when we come back, I'll see what I want to do with that, but definitely liking that, so that may be what I'm going to do next. You know what? They would probably look really good, too, in the flowers. Ooh, very dimensional. Very cool, huh? That would look cool. Well, I like the way the red, I don't even know where I got all these red ones from. Why are they in here? That is like so amazing. They were here just for me. So that would be nice, huh? And there's another flower there. Well, I'm liking that, so I think that's the way to go. I put some beads on this sucker and just really jazz it up. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm just putting some gloss enamel glitter on just the wings, just to make it stand out a little bit, because it's just, you know, so much the same colors as the background. So I wanted to, and I'm only going to put it on the wings to give a little transparent glitter. And then I may go back and put the jewels and stuff on, but, and I'm going to, this looks really pretty. And you could still see all the pretty colors, but the wings have a little special something to them. And I'm going to go over the, white again too, around them, thicken that up a little bit. But I think this is such a fun little painting, and wouldn't it be so cute in a little kid's room? I mean, I think it would be, a little girl, little boy would love that. So this is lots of fun, and now I'm going to work on her little thingamajiggies here. You escaped me, the marker that I wanted to use. Oh, here it is. Okay. You know what? No, because this marker is not waterproof. So let's see. You know, and I just may use paint for that. Let's just get some paint out. Let's see, what do I have? This is the only black one. This is my fine liner. I love these fine liners. And let's get that off of there. Clean the tip a little bit. Okay. And once that dries, I'll work on the white. And then here, I don't know. I may do the background black and then just do these in. I may just paint her black and then just do this little sequins or, you know, jewels on there so they stand out. But let's let this dry and then we'll come back and do that. I'm really liking this glitter. I hope you can see that. See how glittery that is? It's just really pretty. Okay, what I'm starting to do is I'm going to paint the body black on her. So a little brush and some acrylic paint. And this way, if I want to add the beads, I'll have a black background. And I can also just do white dots if I want once I get the black in. And what do I want to paint her face? I'm thinking about, she's got a cute little face. And do something really cute with her. Okay, so let's let that dry. And I think that'll only need a coat. And actually, you know, I never did these up there, so I can go in with the little thin fine liner and do that too. It's just going to be. Make sure. I have to get an even thinner liner. You know, this one is good, but I want one that's even. Thinner. Then I'll go back in with the white. Oops. Get those tops back on, but they are worth the little bit of time it takes to get the cover back on. Just wish all the glues were like that so things don't get clogged up. You know, with these kind of tops, they're great. Okay, so we're almost done. We're almost there, and, you know, if I decide, it's almost dry already, to go with this. See, it's got a nice background already, and I can kind of like do them up there like that. I think like put three there if I want, but I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with her face because it's way too cute. Whoops. So I'm gonna have to maybe use a pencil. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Let me just sharpen this and get this a little bit more pointy. I'm like really clumsy today. I don't know if you guys ever get that way, but I'm like hitting into things. Gosh, it's like Everything seems to be in my way today. Very strange. Oops. I love when you sharpen it and you lose the tip. Using a peachy color. Just to give her a little bit of face color here. It's just too cute. And then I can take a marker and do her eyes and then give her little lips. Little red lips, see if that works. And then some peaky cheeks. Oh, she cute. That may be just a little bit too much cheeky, but see what I have that will write over. That's thin. Oops. Gosh, you see, she's so cute. Okay. The little face. She's adorable. Get my other beads out. And I think I'll use diamond glaze. I always use diamond glaze to put, you know, beads and jewelry on my tiles when I make them. And they seem to work. It seems to keep them on, so. Can't pick this up. Oops. She definitely needs three, so. That's really cute. And then I had wanted to put some flowers. That one there. Try to grab it. I hate when you can't grab something. There we go. What do you think? I think I like that. So, I'm going to get my diamond glaze and glue them down. My hands are so cold today. Oh, I just cannot warm up. Oh, I have the heat on and everything, but it's still, the room is warm. It's just, I can't seem to get my body temperature. But I'll be right back. I'm going to glue them on and I'll be right back. Okay. Look at her. Huh? She's all dolled up. She's got her jewels on, and she's a gypsy, and she is nice and shiny. And what I did there is I used the diamond glaze to paint on the black, but then I decided I wanted it the whole thing to be shiny, so I use the Americana, the acrylic sealer finish, the gloss. And I did a couple of coats of that, and I may do another coat, but for now, and I didn't do the sides yet, so I may spray the sides or I may paint a gloss on the side, I don't know. But you could definitely, you know, if you're using all acrylics, you can definitely just paint over in any kind of finish, decoupage, a decoupage. There's all kinds of acrylic sealers that Americana makes, DecoArt makes, that you can paint over with a brush if you want, or a sponge. But I have some beads on here, so I kind of, when I have texture, I like to spray. But, and also if I have other things going on besides acrylic paint, anything that's water soluble is not, and is not permanent, then I want to make sure I seal it first with a spray before I go over it with a brush and start putting on anything else, because then things start to move and get messy and smear. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I can't wait to see your creations. If you join the No Boundaries group, please share your work there, or you can share on my Facebook page. I'd love to see your work. And don't forget, if you do want that sketch, go over, ask to join the No Boundaries. I will, of course, let you in, and then you can download your free sketch if you'd like. But either way, if you draw the butterfly yourself or you get the sketch from me, I'd love to see it. So thank you so much for being here. And until the next workshop and the next tutorial, you have a creative day, and I'll see you next time, okay? Bye-bye.